Dear candidate, once more, good morning. Here is Moses. Today we are going to focus on Section C, Cameroon history. On the first topic that we are going to focus will fall under the Federal Constitution or Road to Reunification. And of course, under this topic, we are to study topics like the Fuman Constitutional Conference, the Bamenda All Party Conference, and the rest. We are going to study how the Fuman Constitutional Conference certified the aspiration of the Bamenda and how it failed to certify the aspiration of the Bamendas. As we earlier said, good, we are going to have this introduction. As we earlier said, we are under Section C, Cameroon history. Now, the introduction to the Federal Constitution or this topic. You have to understand that following the United Nations conducted plebiscite of February 1961, by which Southern Cameroon or the people of Southern Cameroon voted for reunification with the Independent Republic of Cameroon. Now, after this, it was necessary for the delegate from the two regions to meet and define the specific terms of there will be reunification. The two delegates were from one delegate from Southern Cameroon and a delegate from the Republic of Cameroon. To prepare for such a meeting at Fuman, Southern Cameroonians met in Bamenda in June 1961 in order to lay down proposal for the union. And after this meeting, they met at Fuman and a federal constitution and a system of government was adopted styled the Federal Republic of Cameroon. The Bamenda All Party Conference, June 26 to June 28, 1961, was the first conference organized after the 1961 plebiscite. This conference that was organized in Bamenda was attended by delegates of the KNDP, the CPNC, OK, that is One Cameroon, representative of the House of Chiefs and native authorities. The British government was represented by Billy, Smith and Nixon. Endele, who was a leader of the CPNC, was absent but was represented by N.N. Billy. The Bamenda Conference was organized with the main aim to agree on matters related to the nature of the would-be union. Is it going to be a federal system or a unitary system? They were to decide on the presidential elections. Was the president going to be elected 5 years terms of mandate or 2 years terms of mandate or 3 years or terms of mandate? Then they were to also discuss on the nature of the legislature. Was it going to be a bicameral legislature or was it going to be a single legislature? They were to discuss on the nationality or the citizenship. Were the population going to have the dual nationality or a single nationality? They were to discuss on the federal capital. Was it Yaoundé, Douala, Bamenda, Boya that was going to be the federal capital? They were to discuss on several things like education, the judicial system. For this reason, the Bamenda All Party Conference was organized. Now, dear candidate, dear students, let us analyze the proposals that were made at the Bamenda All Party Conference, or the aspiration of the Southern Cameroon politicians at the Fuman Conference. At the end of the conference, the following agreement were arrived. Southern Cameroonians proposed that the union between Southern Cameroon and the Republic of Cameroon should take a form of a loose federation, with the two federated states commanding considerable powers and influence than the central government. What are they trying to say here? Southern Cameroonians wanted a system of government whereby much power would be at the level of the federal state, while little or limited power would be at the level of the central government. That was what they proposed. As concerned the election of the president, they proposed that the president should be elected on a simple majority by universal adult suffrage for a 5-year terms of mandate renewable twice. It was further proposed that the president should be vested only with ceremonial powers, while full executive powers were to be returned by the different state governments. What are they trying to say here? The proposal that the president should be only should be vested only what ceremonial power means that the president was not going to be the chief of armed force. The president was not going to have the right to appoint and dismiss. Right now, the other proposal that they proposed here was that the post of the president should rotate between the states. What are they trying to say here? If the president was to come from Southern Cameroon today, tomorrow the president will come from where? The Republic of Cameroon. And they also propose that at no one time should the president and vice come from the same state. If the president of the Federal Republic of Cameroon was to come from West Cameroon, the vice president was to come from East Cameroon. They were not to come from the same state. These were some of the proposals the Southern Cameroonians proposed at Bamenda. Dual nationality was recommended via state and federal nationality. That is, Southern Cameroonians proposed for what? A dual citizenship or dual nationality. That is, the nationality of West Cameroon and the nationality of the Federal Republic of Cameroon. Southern Cameroonians also proposed Douala as the capital of the federation, while Boya and Yaoundé were to remain the capital of the federal state. As concerned the judiciary, they proposed the separate existence and development of their different judicial system, most especially the customary court system in Southern Cameroon, until such a time that both systems could merge at the center. Why did they propose a separate judicial system or the existence of separate judicial system? Because Southern Cameroon inherited from the English common law system, which says that before you are being in prison, you must be proven guilty. Why the Republic of Cameroon inherited from the French civil law, which says that whether guilty or not, you are first of all in prison. So they wanted the each state to maintain their separate judicial system so as to not create any confusion. In the domain of education, Southern Cameroonians proposed that higher education should be the responsibility of the federal government, while primary and secondary education should be handled by the federal states. On the domain of the language or national language, Southern Cameroonians proposed that English and French should be adopted as the two official languages. Now, they use this word, but Southern Cameroonians wanted English should be the only working language in Southern Cameroon. Southern Cameroonians also proposed that important ministerial position should be reserved for each federal state. They also proposed that their house of chiefs should be maintained. Of course, they also propose for the respect for the fundamental human rights, freedoms, and liberty in the country. The Fumban Constitutional Conference, July 17 to 21, 1961, is our next subtopic after examining the Bamenda All Party Conference. Remember, the Bamenda All Party Conference was organized in order to prepare for this particular meeting. Now, the Fumban Conference was attended by delegates from Southern Cameroon, led by Prime Minister John Rufoncha, and those from the Republic of Cameroon, led by its President Amadou Ahidjo. The venue of the meeting was at Fumban, right, in a particular quarter known as Njinka, in a particular government school, secondary school known as Government High School Fumban or Lycée de Fumban. Now, why was this Fumban conference organized? We are under reason why the Fumban conference was organized. Now, first, the Fumban conference was organized in order to work out a constitution to govern the union between Southern Cameroon and the Republic of Cameroon. Was it going to be a federal constitution or a unitary constitution? That is why it was organized to choose. The delegate also met in order to decide on the system of government to be adopted in the new Cameroon nation that will preserve and promote their different culture and historical background. Was it going to be a centralized federation or was it going to be a decentralized federation or a decentralized state or a centralized state? The Fumban conference was summoned in order to harmonize the proposal made by the representative of the Southern Cameroons during the Bamenda All-Party Conference and those of the Republic of Cameroon. The Fumban Conference was also to establish the basic for politicians of Southern Cameroonians and those of the Republic of Cameroon. Good. Now, these were some of the reasons why the Fumban Conference was held.
St. Austin's Higher Medical Institute of Learning and St. Austin's Medical Center. Do you have a passion to work in the medical field? Do you wish to see this passion and dream come true? Do you wish to serve humanity through the medical field while having fun? Do you want to become a medical professional or work as nurse, midwife, medical assistant, radiographer, laboratory technician, dentist, or physiotherapist? Then this opportunity is for you. St. Austin's Medical Higher Institute, SAMHI, Carrefour Givens Yaoundé, is your citadel of learning for all medical courses and the training of medical personnel. At St. Austin's Higher Medical Institute of Learning, we are equipped with a modern, beautiful learning environment filled with a state-of-the-art modern medical equipment. SAMHI offers medical learning courses to both First School Living Certificate holders, GCE Ordinary Level or CAP Certificate holders, as well as GCE Advanced Level or BAC Certificate holders. Our medical courses range from 1 year to 3 year programs. We offer training in the following medical fields: nursing, midwifery, radiology technology, medical laboratory science, dentistry, pharmacy technology, physiotherapy technology, medical imaging technology, health sanitary inspector, and others. If you want to realize your dream and passion of becoming a top professional medical personnel, then do not wait any longer. Come register at SAMHI for the academic year 2020-2021. Admissions are currently going on all medical programs. We are currently offering a 10% reduction in fee for the first 20 students who will register this academic year, as well as we also offer scholarships to our best students to study abroad with our partner universities. We offer a free pair of uniforms to all students and a free driving lesson to all our registered students. Admissions are ongoing. Take the opportunity and register now. We offer both daytime studies as well as evening study programs. St. Austin's Higher Medical Institute of Learning also has a well-equipped modern center called St. Austin's Medical Center, situated at Carrefour Givens, where all our students carry out practical training of what they learn in the classrooms. St. Austin's Medical Center offers medical services to the general public in areas such as general consultation, biomedical analysis, facial consultation, admission of patients in its clean, well-equipped general and private wards, vaccination against various diseases, child delivery, radiology, echography, physiotherapy, detoxification and massage, ophthalmology, pediatric services, dentistry, cardiology, gynecology, and neurology. Our medical prices are very affordable, and our patients' well-being is our principal concern. St. Austin's Medical Center is well-equipped and contains the following departments: a well-equipped laboratory for all your medical examinations and tests, an ultra-modern equipped theater for all your surgical problems, a well-equipped session with a modern radiography machine, and above all, we have a highly trained and professional medical team from the best medical schools in and out of the country. At St. Austin's Medical Center, Carrefour Givens Yaoundé, we are ready to serve you diligently and professionally.
decisions or provisions of the Fumban Conference. The following were the main provision of the 1961 Fumban Constitutional Conference. There was the creation of a centralized federation that was styled the Federal Republic of Cameroon, made up of two federate states. The two states were henceforth to be called West Cameroon, that is former Southern Cameroon, and East Cameroon, that is the Republic of Cameroon. The country was to be ruled by an executive president, assisted by a vice president, and both were not to come from the same state. According to the constitution, the president was head of state, head of the Supreme Court, and commander-in-chief of the armed forces. He had the right to appoint and dismiss state and federal ministers. The president and vice were to be elected by universal adult suffrage for a 5-year term of mandate. Another important provision of the constitution was the establishment of the Federal Assembly. This assembly was to have 50 members, with 10 coming from the ruling party in West Cameroon. Any decision taken in the Federal Assembly needed a 2/3 approval of the Federal House of Assembly before its implementation. Each state was to have a House of Assembly. Yaoundé became the capital of the Federal Republic of Cameroon. In this way, Boya was to serve as the capital of West Cameroon, while Yaoundé was to serve as both capital of the Federal Republic of Cameroon and the capital of East Cameroon. English and French were made the two official languages of the federal state or the Federal Republic of Cameroon. The Southern Cameroon House of Chiefs was maintained and it became known as the West Cameroon House of Chiefs. The legal or judicial system operating in the two states were maintained.